सॉलिड स्टेट। दिस इज द फर्स्ट फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री। सॉलिड्स सॉलिड्स आर रिजिड, इनकॉम्प्रेसिबल, दे हैविंग द डेफिनेट शेप एंड डेफिनेट वॉल्यूम। These solids are classified into the two types, crystalline solids and amorphous solids. These crystalline solids and amorphous solids are not in your examination. The next part is a similarity or dissimilarity in a crystal structure of different solid is described as isomorphism and polymorphism. This isomorphism, in this case, iso means same, iso means same, and morphism means phase, same forms, and poly, in this case the polymorphism, poly means the meaning and morphism means phases, poly the maximum phases. Depending on these two forms, isomorphism and polymorphism, there are the different parts are introduced. The definition of the isomorphism. Isomorphism means two or more substances have the same crystal structure, said to be isomorphism. Two or more substances having the same crystal structure, said to be isomorphism. In these substances, the chemical composition has the same atomic ratio. The law of conservation of mass law of conservation of mass, then law of definite proportions, law of multiple proportions are also applied in this isomorphism and polymorphism. Out of these, the first in the substances, the chemical composition has the same atomic ratio, that is the law of definite proportion. For example, in this for example NaF sodium fluoride and MgO magnesium fluoride, and second example sodium nitrate NaNO3 and CaCO3 calcium carbonate are isomorphous pairs. In these two, they having the same atomic ratio, that is in case of the NaF and MgO, the atoms are 1:1 and therefore the ratios are 1:1, and in case of the sodium nitrate and calcium carbonate, the number of sodium, nitrogen and oxygen, and in this case calcium, carbon and oxygen, this ratio is 1:1:3 respectively, and this is a isomorphism. Next is a polymorphism. Poly means different, maximum, in this case meaning a single substance that exists in two or more forms or crystalline structures is said to be polymorphous. Single substance having two or more forms. The polymorphs of the substances are formed under different conditions. For example, the calcite and aragonite are two forms of calcium carbonate. Second, alpha quartz, beta quartz and cristobalite are the several forms of silica, that is silicon dioxide. In this case, if there is a elements are present, then this polymorphism occurs in the elements are called as allotropy. Polymorphism occurs in the elements, then this is called as allotropy. For example, three polymorphic or allotropic forms of carbon are diamond, graphite and fullerene. In this case, diamond is three-dimensional network, while in this case graphite and fullerenes are two-dimensional networks. They are forms a sheet-like structure, and this is a diamond is a three-dimensional structure. The next part is a classifications of crystalline solid. Solids are classified into the two types. First is a crystalline solid and another is the amorphous solid. Out of these, the first part is the crystalline solid. The crystalline solids are further classified into the four categories. Which are those? The first, ionic solid. Second, covalent network solid. Third, molecular solids. And fourth is a metallic solid. This is a metallic solids. Out of this, the first is a ionic solids. These ionic crystals or ionic solids. Ionic crystals have the following characteristics. First is the constituent particles of the ionic crystals are charged ions. These are the charged ions. The cations and anions may differ in their size depending upon the crystal structure. Suppose calcium carbonate, CaCO3 and NaCl. They are different, their ratios of the atomic proportions and their colors are different, and hence the cations and anions may be differ in their size. The particles of ionic crystals are held by the electrostatic force of attractions between oppositely charged ions. These are called as the Coulomb forces. Electrostatic forces are also called as the Coulomb forces. Ionic crystals are hard and brittle. They have high melting points. Ionic solids having the high melting points. These are non-conductors of the electricity in solid state because all the atoms, ions, that is negatively charged or positively charged ions, their valences are satisfied by their transferring their electrons. And hence, in case of the solid state, these are non-conductors of the electricity, but they are good conductors when they melted or dissolved in the water. When they can melt, their charges or the outermost electrons are free to move, but in case of this dissolved water, there is a formation of the ions, positively charged cations and negatively charged anions. At this time only they can behave as a good conductor of electricity. Next is a covalent network crystals. The characteristics of the covalent network crystals are as follows. This covalent solid involves covalent network crystals. The characteristics of network crystals are as follows. The constituent particles of the covalent solids are atoms. In this covalent network crystals, they can form the only atoms. The atoms in these crystals are linked by a continuous system of the covalent bond. There is no any other types of the bonds like ionic bond, banana bond, metal type of the bond, electrostatic force of attractions, van der Waals forces of attractions, Coulomb forces. These forces are does not exist in case of this covalent network crystals. Only they shows the covalent bonds. The results in rigid three-dimensional network that forms a giant molecule. Due to the formation of the covalent bond, they can form the giant molecule, and in case of this covalent network, these are also called as a giant molecule crystals. The entire crystal is a single molecule. As a result of rigid and strongly bonded structure, covalent network crystals are very hard. Due to the presence of the rigidity and strong bonded structure, covalent crystals are very, very hard, like diamond. They are hardest and most incompressible of all other materials. These crystals have high melting and boiling points. due to the presence of high molecular forces of attractions. They are the covalent network crystals are very hard due to the presence of they having the hard and most incompressible in all the materials. Therefore, these crystals have high melting points and boiling points. The covalent solids are poor conductors of heat and electricity. This point, in case of the diamond, carbon forms allotrope of the diamond is an allotrope of this carbon. In diamond, there are four electrons are present. All these four electrons are involved in the sharing of electrons with neighboring carbon atom and forms and for this a covalent network, three-dimensional network, and hence there is no extra electron for transfer the heat or electricity. Hence, the diamond is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. But in case of the graphite and fullerene, it is a sheet-like structure. They can form only the electrons in the bonding, and one electron remains unpaired. Due to the unpaired electrons, graphite is a covalent crystal, but they conduct the electricity because they having the only one free electrons in their outermost shell. Hence, graphite and fullerene are good conductors of electricity, but diamond is a bad conductor or poor conductor of heat and electricity. For example, diamond, quartz, boron nitride, carborundum and covalent network solids. Next is molecular solids. These molecular solids, the constituent particles are the molecules. The constituent particles are molecular solids are molecules. Or unbonded single atoms of the same substances. The substance such as Cl2, CH4, H2, CO2, O2 on the solidification gives molecular crystals. The crystalline organic compounds are also the molecular solids. Chlorine gas, methane gas, carbon dioxide gas, oxygen, they can form solid. Then they are the molecular crystals. The crystalline organic compounds are also the molecular solids. The bonds within the molecule are covalent. The molecules are held together by the various intermolecular forces of attraction. Reference, there is a 11th standard chemistry textbook chapter number 10. For example, the weak dipole-dipole interactions in a polar molecule such as the HCl, H2O, SO2, which possesses permanent dipole moment. In this topic, there is a various types of the forces are present. Dipole-dipole interaction, dipole-induced dipole interaction, weak van der Waals forces of attractions, as well as there is a covalent bonded are also present in that interactions. The weak dispersive forces or London dispersive forces in a nonpolar molecule such as solid methane and hydrogen gas molecule. These forces are also involved in a monoatomic solids like argon, neon, etc. If the noble gas are present, then these types molecular forces are also present in that noble gases or zero group elements. This is also called as the 18 group elements. These substances are usually gases at room temperature. The next is a intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Intermolecular hydrogen bonds in a solid such as the water, ice, solid ice, ammonia, hydrogen fluoride, and so on. These are the different types of the intermolecular forces of attractions already studied in a केमिस्ट्री टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ द 10 चैप्टर नंबर 10 इन 11th स्टैंडर्ड. बिकॉज ऑफ वीक इंटरमोलिकुलर अट्रैक्टिव फोर्सेस मॉलिकुलर सॉलिड्स आर यूजुअली सॉफ्ट सबस्टेंसेस. देर आर वीक इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन डायपोल डायपोल आयन डायपोल इंड्यूस्ड डायपोल एंड हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड. दीज आर द वीक इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन आर प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ दिस मॉलिकुलर क्रिस्टल्स. हेन्स दीज क्रिस्टल्स आर द यूजुअली वेरी एंड ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ दिस सॉफ्टनेस और द सॉफ्ट सब्सटेंसेस दे हैव द लो मेल्टिंग पॉइंट्स. दीज सॉलिड्स आर पुअर इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टर्स एंड आर गुड इंसुलेटर्स. द मॉलिकुलर सॉलिड्स आर पुअर इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टर्स एंड इंसुलेटर्स. दीज पॉइंट्स आर अबाउट मॉलिकुलर क्रिस्टल्स. The next is a metallic crystal. In this metallic crystal, the metallic bond is formed between the positively charged ions of the metal and the electrons present in the metals. The first point of this metallic crystal is these are crystalline solid formed by atoms of the same metallic elements held together by a metallic bond. Same metallic elements are present and they can form. There is a bond between the same elements of the metal, then this is called as a metallic bond. Then the metallic bonds in this case in the solid metal, the valence electrons are delocalized. over entire crystal, leaving behind positively charged metal ions. Therefore, ametallic crystals are often described as one of the positive ions immersed in a sea of mobile electrons called as kernels. The positively charged ions of the metal elements, they are surrounded by the sea of electrons. Then the positively charged ions are called as a kernel. Metallic crystals have the following properties. Metals are malleable, they can hammered into the thin sheets. Metals are ductile, that is, they can be drawn into the wires. Metals have good electrical and thermal conductivity. It has soft to hard, low to high melting points. If the metals are very soft, their melting point is very low. Metals are hard, then melting point of the metals is very high. The attractive interactions between cations and mobile electrons constitute the metallic bonds. For example, metals such as sodium, potassium, calcium, lithium, iron, gold, silver, cobalt, etc. All these are the metallic solids. In this topic, up to this point, we have seen about four types of the crystalline solids: ionic solid, covalent, network solid, molecular solid, and fourth is the metallic solids. All these four points are most important in your HSC board examination for 2 marks. You can write at least 5 points about each types of the crystalline solids. Each points, 2 points for each crystalline solid. The question asks, in examination, write a note on classification of the crystalline solid or how the crystalline solids are classified. Another question separately asked in examinations, write a note on ionic solid or write a note on covalent network solid or water solid or metallic solid. This is a metallic solid. If separately ask the questions, then you can write the 5 points, and the crystalline solid, their classification is asked also, right? There is a 5 points because each point having the half mark, 1/2 marks for these questions. Okay, thank you.